Hi, this is Helena Hart, and in this video, I wanted to talk about what you need to know if you're interested in a man who's really busy or who's having a difficult time prioritizing you or a potential relationship right now. This is something I hear about from the women in my community all the time, and I actually have personal experience with this myself, so I thought I'd create a whole video on this topic today. But before I get started, if you're new to my channel, click the button to subscribe to get all of my latest videos. So I wanted to talk about three different categories of men in this video today. This is my first time ever talking about this, so I'd love to hear from you. I always learn so much hearing about your unique experiences, so make sure to let me know where you're at with this in the comment section or what category the man in question here fits into. So the first category is a man who's not all that interested, but he doesn't want to hurt your feelings, or maybe he just doesn't want to have a straightforward conversation with you and let you know that he's not interested enough to continue pursuing this relationship. This happens in the very early stages of dating. Maybe after a date or two, the guy might say he's really busy and he'll let you know when he gets some free time. And typically in this situation, he'll just fizzle out. He might ghost you, or you just might not hear from him as much, and eventually you'll stop hearing from him altogether. Now, of course, it would be nice if everyone in the world was just really straightforward and sat you down and said that they're just not interested enough to, you know, pursue a relationship with you or something like that. But, you know, the truth is men and women have a hard time with that sometimes. It can be difficult to want to be straightforward. Maybe he doesn't want to hurt your feelings, so sometimes it's just easier to say that he's really busy and he'll let you know when he can get together. And typically men in this category, you know, things will just sort of fizzle. The next category is a man who is actually busy, but he's also highly interested. I actually married a man like this. He works long hours, he's incredibly busy, but he was also, you know, wanting to put both feet in and see where things would go because he was really interested. So a man in this category will prioritize you. You might hear about how busy he is, or like in my case, if you're married to this man or you live together, you'll see how much he works, or, you know, how much he, you know, what he spends his time doing, but it's not going to affect your relationship because you're a top priority to him. Now, in my opinion and experience, this is a very, very small percentage of men who say they're busy in dating actually fall into this category where they're also highly interested, and so they're going to want to prioritize you. And like I mentioned, that you might hear or see how busy they are, but it's not going to really affect your relationship because you know that they'd rather be with you than anywhere else or with anyone else. And so they're going to put both feet in and see where things go. Something my husband told me when we were dating, which I loved, was, you know, I'm really busy, so I actually want to spend my free time with you and create more free time so we can spend that together and really build something here and see where this goes. So a man who's truly busy but also highly interested and sees you as that one woman that he never wants to live without will prioritize you, and his busy schedule isn't really going to affect your relationship all that much because you're a top priority to him. So very small percentage of men that fit into that category. From my experience in my own life, there was just one. The man I married, my amazing husband, Tom, who you guys know, right? I have him on my channel all the time. If you'd like me to bring him on for a video or a live stream on this topic to get a man's perspective from someone who is actually very busy, let me know in the comment section and I would love to do that. We love creating videos together. So I really wanted to focus on this third category of men, and that is a man who may be somewhat busy and he's only somewhat interested, or he's interested enough to see you whenever he can, when he gets some free time, but he's not interested enough to fit into that second category and put both feet in and make you a top priority, you know, along with whatever his other top priorities are. So this is the kind of man that can be easy to get stuck on because we believe what he says. He might tell you that he's looking for a serious relationship, and so we hang on to those words and we ignore his actions. So if a man says, you know, at the beginning when you first met him, yeah, I'm really looking for that someone special, I'd love to get married someday and settle down, but you really only hear from him a couple times a month, or he's only able to see you every 2 weeks or something like that, what happens is with a man like this, the relationship never progresses. It just kind of stays at that same level. And then before you know it, 6 months or more have gone by and you've only seen him a few times, right? And typically basically, I've been there myself in this situation. These are the kind of men we get hooked on because you're likely not attracted to that many men, right? And then one guy comes along, you finally feel these intense feelings of attraction and chemistry. And there's this tendency to kind of wait around endlessly for a guy like this. Because when you're with him, it's probably wonderful. You probably have an amazing time. He probably really does like you, but he's only interested enough to fit you into his schedule where he can. You might start feeling like a backup plan or an option, right? Where you're putting him at the top of your priority list. I know I can't be the only one who's ever done this, so let me know down below in the comment section. I know I hear from women all the time who are just holding out hope for this one guy who probably likes her enough, but he's just, you know, not really available or ready to put both feet in. And so she just kind of waits for him. And then there's no reason for him to make a decision or for him to prioritize her more, because he gets the sense that she'll just always be there waiting. She's probably always available to him, even last minute, right? And with men like this, you just tend to like want to show him every single thing you have to offer. And it's just never quite enough for him to fully commit and put both feet in and put you at the top of his priority list. I've been there myself, and it just doesn't feel good. With men like this, you're always gonna feel the sense of longing for them or just wanting more. They always kind of leave you wanting more in a way that doesn't feel good. Where the man in, you know, the second category, where he may be busy, but he's also highly interested, who you are is enough. You know, he sees you, he knows he's interested, and he's gonna wanna come after you. And eventually, he's just gonna fall in love, and it doesn't take a lot of convincing. It really doesn't take any convincing or prodding or prompting at all with the right guy. So what do you think about these three categories? I'll just recap them. The first one is someone who's not really all that interested. He may or may not be busy, but he doesn't want to be honest and straightforward, so it'll just fizzle out pretty quickly. The second category is a man who is truly busy, but he's also highly interested and motivated to get into a relationship with you. So you may see or hear how busy he is, but it's not going to affect the relationship. He's going to put you at the top of his priority list, just like his other top priorities, and it just feels incredible, right? The third category is this man that we tend to get hooked on, right? He may be actually busy. He may or may not actually be busy, but he's only somewhat interested. He may say he's looking for a relationship, but for whatever reason with you, he's just kind of only interested in seeing you whenever he can fit you into his schedule. So it's important not to get hooked on a guy like that and just try to prove yourself to him and wait around for him endlessly and accept crumbs and tolerate bad behavior and twist yourself into a pretzel to try to like become what you think he wants. All of those things actually decrease his attraction for you and your perceived value in his eyes. So you want to stay away from doing anything like that. And you really want to see these men in this third category for what it is. You know, he may be a great guy that you have a good time with, but this isn't typically the kind of guy who's really ever going to commit to the kind of full-time serious relationship you want, if that's what you're looking for. So again, this is the first time I'm talking about this. I'd love to hear from you. Let me know in the comment section what category of men do you find yourself attracting or attracted to? And if you'd like me to bring my husband on for a live stream or another video on this topic, if you have any questions about any of these categories or anything else, let me know down below in the comment section. Also, don't forget to download my free 3 keys to attract the man you want report and audio training. That's on my website, helenahartcoaching.com. I'll include a link to that in the description of this video. So just click the title of this video. It'll open up the description. That'll be the first link in there. Again, totally free. So I'd love to hear your thoughts on this one. I love you guys, and I will see you next time.